A senior state government minister is calling for an end to development in his northwest Sydney electorate, as some experts declare our city is full. David Elliott is the latest senior Liberal to question Sydney's booming population and the rapid spread of high-rise apartments.
Cranes used to be a rare sight in Sydney. Now they're everywhere, filling the skyline along with sprawling apartment buildings.
Sydney is basically full unless we want it to turn into Shanghai and completely destroy the way of life as we know it today.
A recent ReachTel poll found two-thirds of Sydneysiders agree the city is full, a claim rejected by the pro-growth, pro-development lobby.
We must start moving into a more urban city with greater densities like London, like New York, like most of the big cities when you get to that level.
State Minister David Elliott is the latest to call for a pause on development to build essential infrastructure first. He spoke out after a Malaysian developer announced it will push ahead with a new $3 billion commercial and residential expansion of Norwest Business Park. The irony is that Minister Elliott is part of a government that approved all this planning and development and a member of the Federal Party which set our net immigration at 200,000 a year. What they can't control is where all these extra people choose to live. Overall, the population in New South Wales is 7.8 million. That's up more than 123,000 in just 12 months. So where are all these extra people living? The Parkley-Kellyville Ridge area recorded the largest growth, up 22,000 or 193% over the past decade, followed by Waterloo-Beaconsfield, Concord West, North Strathfield and Cobbetty-Leppington.
Go back to the long-term average of immigration of 70,000 per year. That will stabilise our population.
Many demographers argue growth is unstoppable.
We can't stop the growth. Sydney is the gateway to Australia. We're growing through national migration. We're growing through natural increase.
Adding another 250 people every day. Brian Seymour, 7 News.
We're being told the...